In the third part of this presentation on module 5, I would like to discuss on spillways. A spillway is a hydraulic structure built at a dam site for diverting the surplus water from a reservoir after it has been filled to its maximum capacity. Many of us have seen it, a spillway, in many of the dam structures. Once the water level in the reservoir has gone to maximum water level, it has been disposed of or it has been discharged onto the downstream side through some openings. That openings is what we call as spillway. Spillways are classified into different types on the basis of the arrangement of the control structure, a conveyance channel, and a terminal structure. So this is the list of different types of spillways: straight drop spillway, auger spillway, shaft spillway, chute spillway, side channel spillway, siphon spillway, labyrinth spillway. Now let us look into these different types of spillways. First, let us take the straight drop spillway. This is the figure which I have provided for the straight drop spillway. A straight drop spillway consists of low height weir. This is the weir, right? This is the weir. Having its downstream face roughly or perfectly vertical. When the water level in the reservoir rises above the normal pool level, the surplus water falls freely from the crest of the weir, and hence it is known as straight drop spillway or free overfall spillway. This is the figure which shows that the water level on the upstream side rises, it falls over this. Second is the auger spillway. Auger spillway, as the name says, represents the shape of the downstream face of the weir. It is an improved form of a straight drop spillway. In this case, the downstream face of the weir is constructed corresponding to the shape of lower nap of freely falling water jet, which is in auger shape. Auger shape means enlarged S shape. And that is what this S. When a capital S is stretched, you will be getting in this shape. And that is why it is the auger shape. Auger shape of the downstream face is designed on the basis of principle of a projectile. And say this is one of the most common type of the spillways which are provided in dams. Shaft spillway. A shaft spillway is a type of spillway which consists of a vertical shaft followed by a horizontal conduit. This is the vertical shaft. The horizontal conduit is not visible here. Can I show it? The surplus water enters into the vertical shaft and then to the horizontal conduit and finally reaches the downstream of the channel. The shaft constructed is either artificial or natural. Excavation for the natural shaft is possible only when the hard rocky layer is present on the upstream side. The horizontal conduit either passes through the dam body or through the foundation of the dam. Therefore, it is why you are not visible, that one is a shaft, yeah. In the case of large projects, the inlet hall of the vertical shaft is specially shaped, which is called as morning glory or glory hall of the spillway. Hence, shaft spillway is also called as morning glory spillway or bellmouth spillway. Shaft spillway is recommended when there is no space to provide for other types of spillways, such as auger spillway, straight drop spillway, etc. Chute spillway. Chute spillway is a type of spillway in which surplus water from upstream is disposed to the downstream through a steeply sloped open channel. It is generally constructed at one end of the dam or separately away from the dam in a natural saddle in a bank of the river. Chute spillway is suitable for gravity dams, earthen dams, rock fill dams, etc. But it is preferred when the width of the river valley is very narrow. The water flows along the steeply sloped chute or trough or open channel and reaches the downstream of the river. Chute spillway is also called as trough spillway or open channel spillway. This is that what we have mentioned here. This is the chute. This is the reservoir. This is the, on the other side is the reservoir. So it is, the water will be flown through this chute, steep stop channel. Side channel spillway. Side channel spillway is similar to chute spillway, but the only difference is the crest of the side channel spillway is located on one of its sides, whereas crest of spillway is located between the sidewalls. In other words, the water spilling from the crest is turned to 90 degrees and flows parallel to the crest of the side channel spillway, unlike in chute spillway. Chute spillway is also called as trough spillway or open channel spillway. Next is the siphon spillway. A siphon spillway is a type of spillway in which surplus water is disposed to downstream through an inverted U-shaped conduit. It is generally arranged inside the body or over the crest of the dam. In both types of siphon spillway, air vents are provided at the bent portion of the upper passageway to prevent the entrance of water when the water level is below the normal pool level. Whenever the level rises above normal pool level, water enters into the conduit and is discharged to the downstream of the channel by siphonic action. This is that what is a siphon spillway. Labyrinth spillway is a type of spillway in which the wear wall is constructed in a zigzag manner in order to increase the effective length of the wear crust with respect to the channel width. This is what. This increase in effective length raises the discharge capacity of the wear, and hence higher water flow at small heads can be conveyed to the downstream easily. So, this is all about the basics of the spillways. In the next part, we may be discussing on the auger spillway. What is the effective length of the spillway? How it can be found out, etc.